One hospital is Chulu, basically Chulu Hospital in Cairo. When they discharge his patients, he's to give them financial support. There was a report to say that he gave them 5 pieces of gold to help them support themselves to recover. We'll see the doctor coming in now.
This was on you.
How are you feeling today?
Not great.
Assistant tell me that you have some problem with your eyes.
It's the right one.
Please describe in detail what you see.
Yeah, a few months ago I started noticing that the vision of my right eye is deteriorating. I see blurred vision, spots in my vision. Now on a sunny day, I can't even look at the sun.
Try some shade. Anyway, close your left eye. With your right eye, look around the room. You have trouble differentiating all the colors?
Yes.
You have double vision in your right eye?
Yes.
I think that's too much late night TV. Anyway, lie down. Let me have a closer look.
A little bit in it, yeah.
Assistant, please observe. Take note. I can see a cloudy substance built behind the right eye, behind the lens, yeah? I think that's probably because of poor hygiene. Anyway, please take a look at the observation.
I see a cloudy build-up behind the lens.
Your observation is
starting to see 20 degrees from the vision. But it's clear, doctor. He's obese.
He may have cataract. Excellent.
But I think the word obese didn't exist at that time.
What's wrong?
What's that? You have a cataract.
The word obese did not exist at that time.
I know. I'm just trying to make it more enjoyable.
New terminology for now.
Don't worry, my brother. Allah has given us the means to treat your condition.
Really?
More purpose for the operation.
Okay, I'd like to apologize to the sound system interested to come here. Okay, please bear with us. Now, the doctor diagnosed the problem as cataracts. Yeah? You can see very clearly the doctor and the assistant working together. Now, when they were diagnosing, these type of diagnosis took place. It was very common for the Muslim scientists under the Islamic civilization. They discussed these issues very clearly. Now, one of the books that discusses this was Al-Qanun Fil-Din. The book authored by Ibn Sina, one of the greatest thinkers, known regarded as the father of modern medicine. Now he discussed the conditions, the remedies, the symptoms. From this, we had another great inventor, the great scientist, great physician, in terms of ophthalmology, in terms of eye surgery. The one knows Ibn al-Haytham. In his book, he talks about how the light enters the eye. And from these other surgeons, they start discussing about, as you can see, the intricate details of the eye. They picture the eye, they put the physiological parts, all this. Now we're in the operation ward now. Now, surgery in Europe at the time they used to be done by barbers and cuppers. Now, one of the great surgeons, Abul Qasim al-Zahrawi, in his book, Kitab al-Tasrif, he listed about 200 surgical instruments. Some of these are his own creation, like the scalpel. Like the curettes. That's his own invention into medicine. And that was until the 16th century in Europe. That's about 500 years. These were the basics.
Listen, lie down, we'll begin the operation. What's that?
Bit of rust in it.
It's a scalpel. What are you doing there? We're going to cut into your eye. We need to get access to the cataract. So we need to make a little incision in your eye. What the hell is that?
You don't have to worry. This is just a hypodermic needle.
What are you gonna do with that?
We're gonna poke it into your eye.
We have to suck out the cataract after we make the incision.
Okay, no operation. Use a scalpel and make the incision in your right eye, and then use a hypodermic needle, and then through suction get the substance out of the eye.
Right, let me get this straight.
Yes.
You're going to cut my eye with a scalpel.
Yes.
You're going to stab me with a needle.
Yes, that's great.
What? Hey!
Don't worry about the pain, my brother. It won't be an issue. Sister, get the sponge.
The issue of pain, yeah? Anesthetic. You know, anesthetic discussed by the Muslim scientists in many of their books. They produced many encyclopedias. One such book is even Sina, he discussed about in his book the perfect fungus that you can see here. Now this is to be soaked in our narcotics and aromatics. Basically some drugs here. So, that the person is inhaling. And that is another patient. As you can see, gonna get, you may get be addicted to it. The patient is now in an anesthetic state.
Let's begin. What's this?
Let's have a decision.
Yes, it's the right time. Okay, assistant, make sure. Please observe, as one day you have to perform the operation by yourself. Scalpel, please. Take the scalpel and have to do the needle.
Okay, the procedure being carried out for suction. This technique was first invented by Ammar ibn Ali. That's in the 11th century. Now the method before doing that was the couching method, which was very painful. Now anyway, 99% of this extraction, this cataract extraction, is using NHS, 99% that method.
Apply the antiseptic now, and expand it in the right eye, and please move into the one of the wards, hospital wards, but make sure it's separated from the quarantine patients, yeah?
Okay.
And leave the bandages for 7 days.
Okay.
Okay, there are many things that the doctor mentioned here. Anesthetics. Sorry, not anesthetic. Antiseptic. Now, antiseptic was discussed by many scientists of the Islamic Club. They discussed the effect in the body. Now, one of the great scientists was Muhammad ibn Zakaria Razi. Now, what he discussed, he was known as the father of pediatrics, the great pediatrician. Now, he discussed the issue of antiseptic very clearly in his book. He also was the first to invent a method to deal with chickenpox. That came in Europe. He was also the first on record to differentiate between the smallpox and the measles. Now, as you can see a bandage here, the first bandages developed, Muhammad Abu Qasim al-Zahrawi, for example. He invented the plaster cast. The plaster cast that you see in hospitals, that came from Abu Qasim al-Zahrawi. Now quarantine, that was also mentioned by the doctor, to separate the patient. Now we know even Sina discussed that in his book, Al-Qanun al-Tibb, because he understood the contagious nature of diseases. Now this was the time, remember brothers and sisters, this was the time in the 11th century, a time in Europe, where lepers and mentally ill people were banished from society because people thought they were cursed. We are now in a final act. It's after 7 days.
How are you feeling?
Nervous.
Nervous? Why are you feeling nervous? Inshallah, today we're going to take off the bandage and you see the result. You should have your eyesight back. Be in a positive frame of mind. There's no need to be nervous.
But my right eye.
That's your nose turn.
Come on, brother, only kids get nervous. Come on, we're up.
I'm not going to cry!
Don't be nervous! Relax, the doctor will tell you the same thing. No need to be nervous. Oh, doctor, tell him.
How are you feeling today?
Nervous!
Nervous? Are you? Well, you should be nervous. Last time I was something, they went blind. I'm sure my assistant explained that to you. Okay, then I'll take a seat. Assistant, I'll help you with him.
Might take you a few pictures.
No. Stand up. This is the thing of bandage off, please. Slowly. All right, thanks, folks.
70. What is this? Okay.
Is this that bad? Okay. Go to the left eye with your left eye. Open your right eye slowly. Slowly, don't open it all at once. Has your vision, so open it slowly. Has your vision improved?
Praise be to God!
Alhamdulillah!
I can see!
Alhamdulillah! Okay, that was a small insight to an amazing civilization, only from African medicine. Remember, I'm left with two questions to bring about. What was the overall system behind this? And where are its personalities today? Now, the system behind this was the Islamic State, which sponsored the first hospital, sponsored medical centers, helped the doctors, funded them in their techniques, in their research. And it was on these kind of environments that we talked about the Khalifa Harun al-Rashid, the Khalifa al-Walid, al-Muqtadir. Indeed, they created certain personalities. That we mentioned Ibn Sina,
Al-Zahrawi,
Ammar ibn Ali, and but there are hundreds that we have not mentioned, my brother. Hundreds, like Ibn Rushd, like Ibn Zuhr, like Al-Majusi, Al-Maqrudi, Al-Ghazali, Al-Hindi, and so on and so on. When we see this, we ask ourselves, where are the Muslim personalities of today? Where are the personalities in the Muslim land? And this is because it's in the absence of an Islamic ruler, a sincere ruler, the Islamic Khilafah in the Muslim land. We are replaced by rulers who care more about their pockets and their kingdoms, rather than putting effort in the scientific fields. The Islamic Khilafah is built upon the Quran and the Sunnah. These Islamic values and the state embodied used to be the foundation, the driving force for a whole field. They excelled in many of the fields. I hope everyone enjoyed this little play, giving us an experience how things were like when it created one of the greatest scientists, greatest thinkers of all time.